And beware, these Jayhawks can play a little football too. Today, we have one of those games that tests your focus. Top 25 team against an unranked opponent, can you take care of business? As we'll see a squad from the Mountain West, the UNLV Rebels, taking on the 21st ranked team in the land, the Kansas Jayhawks. Glad to have you with us for EA Sports College Football. I'm Reese Davis, David Pollack and Jesse Palmer with me in the booth. Guys, we are ready to tee it up. And the Jayhawks will kick it away first. He'll bring it out from inside his own 10. Not a lot of space to be found. Good hustle by the coverage team, and they stop him at the 21. So UNLV's offense will get the first possession of the game. And as we watch this wide receiver come onto the field, when you have a dude like this, you find ways to get him the ball over and over again, no matter what the defense tries to take away.
Yeah, because the defense can't win. Whether you double team him, we're still going to win. And they're going to give him the ball on quick passes. They're going to throw it deep, and they're going to take advantage of him every opportunity they can. They will feed him. They will feature him because he's just that good.
That big play is just what they needed. Now they have it first and 10 just outside the 40. They'll run the option. Good pickup on that play. It'll bring up second and 4. Went to the running game on first down. Now here they come again. Back to throw. It's Sluka. Quick strike complete. And a good job of coverage by that defense. Just a short pickup. Third down coming up after the completion. He'll try to get it through the air. Going for it all. And good hands there by the defense on that shot to the end zone. So they'll send out the field goal unit. Looks as if this will be a 51-yard attempt. He got it. And that'll put the first points of the game on the board. It's 3-0.
I'll tell you, this is not an easy place to play on the road, especially at nighttime. This crowd, they get loud. That's the way it's been so far, but they have a nice drive to open it up. They're able to execute. They put themselves in field goal range, knock it through the uprights. They did exactly what they needed to do, taking a 3-0 lead here early on the road. That's impressive.
They'll kick it away after putting up a field goal on that last drive. Here's the return from inside his 10. Nice job executing all of the assignments as they put a stop to that return at the 22. The Jayhawks offense will go to work for the first time today. As we take a look at our impact players for this game, David, what do you look for to make an impact from your leaders?
Your leaders not only have to lead the football team, but they got to step up and make plays on the field, keep everybody calm. These guys typically do a really good job of it.
Yeah, David, and they also generally set the tone for their respective football teams. Regardless of which side of the ball they play on, the teammates look towards them to step up in big games like this.
They make the stop, trying to pick up just a little bit at a time to get to that first down marker. Quarterback on the keeper. It's a game of first downs, and they've got one out to their own 37. The Jayhawks come to the line with a new set of downs. Looking to pass, it's Daniels. Fires to the big fella. They make the stop after the catch, and still some work to do to pick up that first down. Completion a little short of the sticks, it's second down. Now the play fake. Quarterback on the move, still looking. He'll be tackled at the 49 after a pickup of 5.
It's just so nice as a coaching staff when you've got quarterbacks who make good decisions. And on a second and short play, you're throwing it, you're trying to catch the defense napping, you might take a shot, nothing there. Go get it yourself. Make the right decision to keep it, not panic, and get you a fresh set of downs.
He'll keep it himself. Makes it past the marker. They'll finally drag him down, but not before he gets it to the 40, and it's a first down. Give to the back. And how about that interior defense stuffing the run for nothing? Got stuffed on first down. It's second and 10. On the move. Only a couple there, and now staring at 3rd and 8. They line up with some serious work to do if they want to convert this one. 3rd and long, and he'll try to throw for it. Avoids pressure. Got rid of it just in time. And the 3rd down pass is incomplete. And the Jayhawks will line up to punt it away. He ought to be able to use his first punt to pin him deep. And he can't quite get it down or out of bounds. It's into the end zone for a touchback. UNLV ready to go back to work on offense. Man, how comforting is it to know that even if your offense stalls out a little, Jesse, that field goal kicker can knock it in from a long way out.
Well, he's one of the best in the country, Reese, no doubt. But this offense would like him and prefer for him to kick an extra point on this drive. And to do that, David, they've got to have more rhythm on offense.
Yeah, create some more rhythm, create some more explosive plays, and maybe some more balance. And listen, it's nice to have that weapon and kick long field goals. You kick too many field goals, you don't get very many W's.
Now on the option. Now the pitch. And he's a real nowhere man tackled in this no-gain land. They got nothing on the last play. It's 2nd and 10. Looking downfield, it's Sluka. Good timing on the quick out. Didn't pick up a lot there. Moved it forward just a few. If they can convert here, that type of play can really give you a shot of momentum. And they can't make the connection on 3rd down. And the Rebels will bring the punt team onto the field. A fairly short distance here toward the sidelines, not his best work. Kansas gets the ball back, and the Jayhawk offense is ready to go to work. That last one looked like a back-breaking drive, David, but they ended up punting.
Yeah, and they put some plays together, put some yards together, but the most important stat is putting points on the board. And this offense has to finish, Jesse, when they get across that 50-yard line and start getting in scoring territory.
Yeah, there was some good execution, no doubt about it, but I think it's the critical down and distances. 3rd down in particular, they've got to be better moving forward.
Guys, that's the end of the quarter, and UNLV has the edge. And we've come to the end of the first as we take a moment to check out the stats so far. Lots of time left, and we're ready to get back to it and open the 2nd period. Trying to impose their will with the run. And they make the tackle, but he has plenty for the 1st down. Here's this offense with a fresh set of downs. To the air on 1st down. Firing to the right, complete. And they'll shove him out of bounds after the short gain. After the short completion, let's see if they go back to the air. He's going to pass on 2nd down. Here he goes, breaking the pocket. The quarterback scrambled around, but the defense able to scramble him and turn it into a sack. The number one job is to protect your quarterback, and they weren't able to do it long enough that time.
This offensive line, Reese, they've got to do a better job communicating pre-snap and try and figure out which people on defense are going to be rushing the passer. Right now, this offense just looks confused up front.
3rd down conversion's always a huge stat, and they've got a 3rd and long from the 27. Fires to the right. Got his man all by himself. And he was loose and not stopped until he gets to the 47-yard line.
That's what's so scary about this offense. They've got guys in the perimeter that can change the game in one single play, and you saw it right there. Too much speed on the perimeter to create that explosive play.
The Jayhawks are flying down the field. The offense showing motion from the tight end, trying to get a read on the D. Off the play fake on 1st down to throw. And he got smacked just as he released the pass. It's incomplete. They'll line up for a 2nd down play. They'll give it to the back. They'll give him 4 on that one. It's 3rd and 6. Trying to pick up a 1st down. Dropping back, it's Daniels. Throwing right. Already find a hole in that secondary. And chunk plays are the name of the game, and they get one here before the defense finally makes the stop.
And the quarterback knew exactly where he wanted to go with the football, had time, spins the ball deep. Nice job by this offense, understanding what the defense is giving them and creating the explosive play.
And the Jayhawks have it with a first and 10. They've marched to the red zone, and here they go. Quick completion on the out route. And that defense doesn't allow a cutback, and they get him out of bounds after a short gain. A running back has it. Give him about a yard on the play. It's down at the 10. The terrain gets rough this deep in the red zone. Third down, they can't pick up the first without scoring. He wants it all. It's broken up and almost intercepted in the end zone. It'll be fourth down. They're happy enough to try to take the points as the field goal unit heads out. Splits the uprights, it's good. And that's going to tie it up. And we're all square as he's set to kick it away. On the move from inside his five. He was hoping for something a little more dynamic, but they get him on the ground at the 20. The UNLV offense ready to return to the field. That last drive fizzled out, Jesse. They had to punt it.
Yeah, they did. And David, they're just going to have to do a better job this time around erasing the mental mistakes.
And just trying to solve the defensive riddle, understanding what they're trying to do to you and attack them.
Use the play fake. Now to throw. Got it in the middle. It's White. And he was off to the races, and he gets it to the 45. The Rebels headed quickly to the line.
When you run those routes, those curl routes just like that, those DBs are going to break when you go to throw the football. So you better put that thing on a line. And the QB did there. Put it on a line. Great job. Great catch. First down.
That is exactly what you're looking for when you talk explosive plays. The defense finally able to make the stop. Not the most productive half for this offense so far, but finally starting to get it in gear. First and 10. Looking for space. It's Thomas. And he's able to find a little bit of running room before they get him down.
And a nice job by the running back finding space, getting downhill, making the good run. Great job finishing with his pads.
Operating in the red zone here on second down. From the gun, they'll try the middle. Able to get a couple on the play. He's down at the 9. Boy, they love to move the sticks here and take a shot at it on first and goal. The option look. We'll take a quick break as we have reached the final 2 minutes of the first half. And the Rebels are threatening on first and goal. They'll try to slam it in. And he takes it in for the score. Touchdown, UNLV!
And that is exactly what you want from your offense. Man, late in the half, you want to execute and then punch it in physically on the ground. Take the lead going into the half. Take all the momentum. Nice execution on the drive by that offense.
They'll try to add another to their lead. And the extra point is true, and they're on top by 7. So it's an 80-yard drive, and they finish it off with a short plunge into the end zone. From inside the 10, here he comes. Nice job executing all of the assignments as they put a stop to that return at the 22. The Kansas offense returns to the field. Looking for a man. It's Daniels. He's got his man. He will step out of bounds, but not before the big pickup and a first down for this offense. He wants to throw. And the defense is all over the quarterback, and down he goes.
That's a good example there of complementary defense. The DBs and linebackers are playing zone, they're playing their spaces, and they force the QB to have to hold the ball, try to work through his progressions, and then the pass rush, they win up front.
That sack gets this offense behind the chains. It's second down. He's looking to throw. And the pass is incomplete thanks to a big hit. Ball's at the 27. This offense facing a third and long. Leaves it with the running back. And Shore tackling there to keep him from getting to the first down marker. Timeout called here by the defense. It's the first one they've used this half. The Jayhawks will punt this one away. This will be the second time they've had to kick it away. He'll call for the fair catch here. The offense set for a first down play. Looking to move it through the air. That's reeled in. It's Thomas. Really confident throw and catch there. Big pickup, and they have a first down. Here's this offense with a fresh set of downs. They'll throw it on first down. Looking down the middle. Got his man.
All right, second quarter, getting closer to the half. Offense is still having a lot of success stringing some first downs together. Defense is going to need to figure something out before they get to halftime.
They'll throw it to the back on the screen. Not a whole lot of room there on that screen pass as it just never developed. And here comes the offense on second down. It's complete to the left. And he'll step out of bounds after a very productive play. They've worked it down to the 30. This defense standing tall, trying to force a field goal try. Looking to throw it, Sluka. The quick out. The offense calls timeout. It's the second one they've used this half. The Rebels have it with a first and 10. He's gonna pass. A strike downfield. Touchdown, Rebels! Hauled it in and just kept right on running to the Hallelujah Land. That touchdown puts them up by at least two scores. Too early to say it's over? Probably, but boy, it's starting to feel that way.
It might not be over, but you're in trouble, and you better find some answers really, really quickly. This team is putting everything together, and right now you got nothing going. Come on, give me something.
Lining up to tack one more onto that lead. And with the extra point, they push the lead out a little further. They got the late touchdown on the board, now about to kick it away and hoping the defense can keep them from answering. He'll bring it back from inside his five. Didn't find any crease in that kickoff coverage, and he'll be stopped at the 17. Kansas gets the ball back, and the Jayhawk offense is ready to go to work. Now, they're backed up here, Jesse. Wonder how aggressive they're willing to be.
I think it's going to come down to how much confidence they have in this quarterback and his decision-making, because you cannot throw an interception at this part of the field with this little time left.
And I think that's conversations you've had with the young fellow on the sidelines, being like, what are you comfortable with right here that we can run? Maybe stay aggressive, but make sure I don't make that mistake.
Give to the running back. And after that short game, they'll head to the locker room. It's halftime here. We've played two quarters here. Time to go to Kevin Connors in our halftime update.
All right, fellas, looks like we've got a great atmosphere there today in Lawrence. And there is no better place to start this halftime than by reviewing how this wideout has been a one-man wrecking crew. The kid's been everywhere. And I love how he's willing to go across the middle, but that he also has the jets to burn these DBs on the deep ball. If this defense wants to actually come back in this one, they better hide his cleats. And with that, let's kick it back to the guys at Kansas Memorial Stadium.
Here he comes from inside his own five. Nice job by the kickoff team. Everybody stayed in their lanes, and they'll stop him at the 16. The Kansas offense returns to the field. Maybe adjustments or attitude adjustments, but they've got to find a way to run the ball at least some here in the second half.
I do think you said something that's important. I think running the football is an attitude. Like, it starts with the offensive lineman and being physical, having a nasty attitude, running back.
And the defense makes a play, sacking him back at the 10.
Well, the defense knew coming into the second half here they were going to have to crank up the pass rush, right? They've got the lead. They're going to be seeing this quarterback drop back. How can you affect him? You've got to win up front one-on-one and get home, and they did there on third down.
And this offense just can't afford not to get the first down here. Already trailing big, and the clock is not their friend. Got him downfield. And they are pushing the ball down the field. A big pickup on that one, and the tackle is finally made.
Man, this offense is so dangerous, Reese. They've got dudes all over the field that can make plays. There's a big gainer in the pass game.
You get a chunk of yards like that, now the defense is really on its heels. What an impact from that last explosive play. They were pinned down in their own territory, now first and 10 from their own 45. A 7-yard pickup. It'll be second and 3. Win with the running game on first down. Now back at it. Looking to throw. It's Daniels. Firing deep. He's got it inside the 15. And he was loose and in the open field and on his way. A tremendous pickup on that one. In search of their first touchdown of the game, they are on the move with a first and 10. Fast motion from the offense. Touch pass on the jet sweep. You'll take 4 yards on first down every time, second and 6. He's looking to throw. Got it! That completion will take it inside the 4, and the offense is threatening. Tight quarters deep in the red zone, but they can pick up a first down without scoring. Third down. Makes the catch. They'll get him stopped just short of the end zone, but they're in business here with a first down. Trying to bully their way in. And he takes it to the house. Touchdown, Jayhawks. Well, 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 somebody's been doing their box jumps.
You ain't lying. Getting up in the air. Hey, listen, I'm taking a picture of that, saving it. That might be my screensaver on my phone. That vertical way up in the air.
They'll try to tack one more on their score. And with the extra point, they close it to 17-10. Lining up to cover the kick after that touchdown drive. On the run from inside his own 5. Really disciplined job by the coverage unit to get down there and make the stop at the 19. Guys, the running Rebels offense ready to go back to work. Caught behind the line. It's Thomas. And the defense had that one well covered, just a short game there. Right on target with that last pass. Now it's second and medium. Power football with the run. Yeah, it's a bit of a surge, and he's knocked down after picking up 3 to the 26. Facing a third down and short from the 26. Dropping back, it's Sluka. And they can't make the play on third down. And the Rebels line up to punt it away. This will be the second time they've had to kick it away. Makes a move. That nifty return sets up the offense and negates some of the yardage on the punt. The offense lining up for a first down play. He's looking to throw it. Snagged in the middle. It's Casey. How about this backer in pass coverage and bringing the big hit stick with him too? The give to the back. And he was fortunate not to lose yardage on that play, able to wedge it back to the line of scrimmage. Even if they don't convert, picking up a few would give them a decision to make on fourth down. It's third. Caught at the 25. Ripped off a huge chunk play on that one as he gets the first down before he steps out of bounds.
Really nice timing on that throw. Quarterback had to hold it, allow his receiver to work his route, but he threw it at the perfect moment so that he was able to make the catch inbounds right on the sideline.
And the Jayhawks getting set on first and 10. On the run, it's Neal. A most efficient pickup of 6 on first down. It's 2nd and 4. Now the offense trying to operate in the red zone. The play action fake. Throws to the wideout. Snags it. Takes it to the house. Touchdown, Rock Chalk.
One of the reasons this offense is so exciting to watch, they've got guys that are dangerous after the catch. If this quarterback gets through his progression, David, he hits you in stride, these guys will take it to the house.
Man, it's your job to do the rest, right? You hit me in stride where I don't have to stop running, I don't have to break down. It makes it so easy, the connection between quarterback, wide receiver. You can tell this is a good one, and that's why they got 6 on that play.
Ready to try the point after. And the extra point was good. No incident there. And we are tied up in the third. A very efficient 5-play scoring drive. And the capper, a 19-yard toss for the touchdown. And he takes this from inside the 5. He was looking for some running room, but not much to be found as he stopped at the 18. UNLV ready to go back to work on offense. Last time, David, it was 1-2-3 kick.
The last drive, that 3-and-out, sometimes that puts your defense in a bad spot, and you got to get a drive together here so you don't wear the defense out.
I just think, David, too predictable, that last drive. They got to do something here to get this defense on their heels.
Catch in the middle, it's Thompson. They make the stop, but not before they do their work up top and pick up a first down.
Excellent throw by the quarterback. Found the window between the zones and then delivered the ball on time.
Time winding down in the quarter as they come to the line. They fought tooth and nail through 3, and it is all locked up as we take a look at the stats. This is when winning plays are made, and we start right now in the 4th. With the first down, they'll put it in play from the 33. On the option. Finding a way to put that foot in the ground and get it up to the 37-yard line. Solid pickup of 4 on first down at 2nd and 6. They'll run play action. Well, the quarterback can make a big play when he starts moving around. He's going to be able to pick up a few yards before the slide. Come to the line at the 42, facing a 3rd and short. He's right on target. He's out of bounds, but not before picking up enough for the first down. They'll try to get the edge with the toss play here. Able to scrounge 3 yards out of that one somehow. It's 2nd and 7. Tried to pound it on first down. Now back to the line. Scanning the field. It's Sluka. And that pressure just engulfed him. A sack for this defense.
This defense, they are tenacious. And they've got guys up front that are athletic and that are so strong and then can collapse the pocket. You saw it right there in that play action attempt.
Seventh play of the drive coming up, but a long way to go on third down. Looking to throw, and he needs a bunch. Fires to the middle. Got his man downfield. There to make the tackle, but the big throw is good enough to give them a first down. To the ground with the back. And that's a very productive first down play in bringing up 2nd and 3. Wide receiver coming across in motion. Quick pass on the jet motion. And maybe he'll get back to the line of scrimmage, but no more than that. They come to the line 3 yards away from the first down marker. They've converted twice on this drive. And the defense knew exactly where that first down line was, and they stopped him short. So here we are on fourth down, and this field goal kicker is going to face all the pressure in the world. Oh, the attempt is no good. And in the final quarter of regulation, we remain tied. Kansas gets the ball back, and the Jayhawk offense is ready to go to work. That last drive, an absolute aerial assault for the touchdown, Jesse.
It was a nice job in play calling, too, David, just giving the quarterback some easy looks and reads so he could go out and execute.
And he knew exactly where to go with the football. Everything looked really, really easy. He was hot. The ball was coming out of his hands. The defense better do something different.
Finds his way for three out to the 33. Pivotal moment, perhaps even a decisive play coming on third and three. To the ground to try to pick up the first. And they did not let him get to that first down line. It'll bring up a call here. The Jayhawks send out the punt unit. He gets a block. Returns like that are why you don't settle for the fair catch if you don't have to. Picks up just a little bit of yards to help out the O. They're going to throw it to start the drive. Grabbed in the middle, it's Thompson. Stopped at the 47 after a 10-yard gain. Here comes the offense on first and 10 from the 47. The give from the gun. And a decent gain there before the defense makes a stop. The clock has stopped as we have reached the two-minute warning here in the ballgame. Looking for a man, it's Sluka. And it'll be incomplete. This is some physical pass defense. They need to get a little closer for a field goal try, and they've got to do it in a hurry. On third down, going up top. Got it in the middle, it's Thompson. And they'll finally get him down after a terrific pickup. Finally, some signs of life from this offense, which has done nothing in the second half. It's first and 10. Now he's going to break the pocket. And the pressure will get there. The sack. Down he goes in the waning moments. That could be a costly play. They gave up the sack on first down. Now it's second and 11. He's looking to throw. Shoots it to the left. Complete downfield. The defense uses their second timeout of the half as they try to get their act together. The Rebels will snap it on first and 10. Looking for a gap, it's Thomas. And this one will be stopped for no gain. Looks as if we have an injury on that last play, and we'll take a break to check him out. Got stuffed on first down, it's second and 10. They'll try the left side. Got some room, entered to the goal line. Touchdown, Rebels! And they grab the advantage, taking the lead here in the fourth.
Man, and how about this offense in crunch time, doing what they do, getting six on the board. Now, I turn to my defense right now. I said, boys, we need one more stop. Go out there, get me one more.
He'll try to tack on one more. The extra point is good, and now in the fourth, they're up by a touchdown and an extra point. They took it 64 yards right down the field, and it was capped off with an impressive 16-yard run for the score. He'll start the return inside his five. He was looking for more running room, but none to be found as he stopped at the 23. The Kansas offense returns to the field. They'll crank up this drive with a pass. Excellent coverage and good use of the hands to knock it away. All wideouts, no backs. Right back up top on second and 10. And they can't make the connection. Now facing a third and long. To the air, it's Daniels. Throws for the tight end. For the third straight play, the pass falls incomplete. And here we go, down a score. They'll go for it on fourth down. He'll try to throw and pick up the first down. He's got it, and they convert. Building momentum, picking up a chunk of yardage, moving the chains out to the 34. Looking to go up top on first down. Caught over the middle, it's Casey. And that is good versatility there, and a big hit from the backer in pass coverage. He spikes it, clock stops as they try to rally late. Got to get everybody lined up quickly, time winding away, and they've got to push the ball down the field. He'll throw on third down. Unloads to the wideout. All kinds of room to throw that one in there. And he'll ramble to the 34 before he's finally knocked down.
Well, I think on that play you saw why this guy's such a big weapon in this offense. At receiver, he does such a nice job with his routes. He's patient, and he's consistent, and he's got good hands. You don't see him put a lot of balls on the ground. Nice job there picking up the first down.
And they'll spike the ball to try to save as much time as they can. Now on second down. He's looking to throw. Just a little off. Incomplete. This drive was clicking along, but after a couple of misfires, threatening to stall out on third and 10. How about that play to get a hand in there and force the incompletion? This late in the game, there's really no question about it. To have any chance to tie this thing up, they have to convert here on fourth down. It's incomplete, and they desperately needed to keep that drive going, and they couldn't make the connection. Looks like the offense will just take a knee.